everybody. Welcome back to Media Moogle. It's iOldGamerJoe here with another Media Moogle review. Today we're taking a look at an indie fighting game called Fly Punch Boom, which will be released on Steam and the Nintendo Switch as of May 28th, 2020. It comes from Jolly Punch Games, and the game supports up to 4 players locally and 2 online. Fly Punch Boom allows you to select between a bunch of different characters. The game refers to them as the Punchies. The Punchies are, quote, immortal, sexless beings that reproduce through combat. When two Punchies of great power fight together, the meeting of their fists can generate enough energy to create stars and galaxies. Okay, so despite the game's claim of having an anime style, I wouldn't exactly call this an anime caliber storyline, but that's okay. One thing that is similar to an anime, though, is the way that you'll traverse around the game's different environments. In what feels like something out of a Dragon Ball game, you'll dart across these pretty large levels that have a lot of environmental hazards for you to deal with and use against your opponent. But the gameplay isn't exactly similar to something you would find in a Budokai game. No, it's more of a rock, paper, scissors type system that they've implemented. You'll need to get close enough to your opponent to engage them in a clash by pressing the X button. Once you've entered the clash state, you have the option of pressing X again, which beats the B button, pressing the B button, which beats the Y button, or pressing Y, which beats X. You'll also have an on-screen bar to worry about, and pressing the button at the right moment will result in max damage. There are standard attacks, which might require you to continually mash on the X button after the fact. There's also throws, which you can use to throw your opponents into those environmental hazards that I mentioned earlier. But in my experience, your best shot at victory in this title is grabbing the different power-ups that appear on screen, which will help you to get a very special attack. These attacks will do pretty good damage to your opponents, allowing you to ring them out, which can end in a spectacular fatality move. Okay, so if you're still with me, there's really only one other button to worry about in the game, and that's the left trigger, which can be used to teleport if you want to find your way out of danger, or in the case of the 2v2 mode, you'll use it to tag in your partner. So, my take on this system, I think it is not as fun as if this game were just designed to be a regular fighting game, to be honest with you. I was not a fan of having to worry about all of these different buttons and the timings and all of the different meters that are on the screen. More often than not, I found myself just wanting to go up to my opponent and bash their face in with the X button instead of getting tied up in this weird system of button combinations, but I will say that it is something a little bit different, but I ultimately felt like it slowed the action down in a way, despite the fact that there's so much going on screen in this title. I think it would have been really cool darting around the different areas, shooting fireballs from a distance, dashing in and punching each other with some really cool cinematic animations, but unfortunately the game ultimately feels bogged down by its own systems. One thing I do have to say though is despite the fact that I didn't find Fly Punch Boom that fun to actually play, it was always entertaining to look at with some really crazy animations going on, and some of the fatalities are hilarious and well done. Each character has wonderful art design and great personality to them with fantastic animations, and some of these characters will also need to be unlocked, I should mention, so there is replayability. The environments are fun, bright, and colorful. It's really cool to see your character get knocked into some of the obstacles and the animations that play out. There's over 40 fatality animations in the game, so there's a lot of different outcomes that can happen in a given battle. It's an absolute joy to look at and watch from a distance, there's no denying that. The excellent art and animation is also backed by a really rocking anime soundtrack that I really did enjoy quite a bit, and it's perfectly fitting for the game's battles. Fly Punch Boom looks and sounds like a cartoon brought to life, and it's definitely an enjoyable spectacle to take in. If only then Fly Punch Boom were more fun to actually get your hands on and play. Well, it unfortunately isn't. I pretty quickly got bored of the rock-paper-scissor gameplay elements and always wished I were bashing in my opponent's face instead and using projectiles from a distance. Having really cool epic anime battles is slowed down so much by the gameplay implementations that they've made here. Still though, if you're willing to put up with some of these gameplay shortcomings, there's lots of destructive animations to be seen here, tons of fatalities, a really good soundtrack, and a wonderfully likable art style. Unfortunately, Fly Punch Boom is a fun game to watch, but not a fun game to play. For more on Fly Punch Boom and all of our other content, head on over to MediaMoogle.net, where we have some wonderful podcasts like I Dream of Indie for you to check out, and if you have enjoyed our video coverage today, please do consider hitting the subscribe button below. If you really like us, you can head on over to patreon.com/MediaMoogle, where we have 3 great tiers of content to choose from, or feel free to leave a donation in the description box below. However you end up supporting Media Moogle, thank you so much for helping us to bring a voice to the voiceless ones in gaming.